friends, this is Fried, author of My Burnt Orange. Today, I'm going to make a very traditional Botswana dish, which I've been dying to make for ages and just didn't have the guts to make it. So I just thought I would step right in, and the dish I'm making today is called Seswaa. So what is Seswaa? Seswaa is a type of it's slow-cooked, pounded beef. Now, it is not ground beef because you slow-cook the meat, which would typically be on the bone, until it's, you know, ripe and ready to fall off. And then traditionally, at weddings or any big event, men will come together around this three-legged pot and start pounding it with wooden spoons, and that's how you get the pounded beef. So today, how I'm going to make it is, I bought some meat suitable for slow cooking. I don't know what cuts of beef are, but I asked the butcher, you know, can I slow cook with this, and you know, this is what I found. Unfortunately, it was not on the bone. You know, there's something about England and boneless meat. I can't even find T-bone steak around here. Okay, but this is what I've been told. So all I'm going to do is brown this and then put salt, water, and I'll put a whole onion in, not chop it, just because that's a me thing. Going to use some bay leaves as well, just to, you know, see how it turns out. But simply, it's a very simple recipe, just the beef, the water, the salt. Slow cook it for how many hours you like, whether it's 2, 3, 4, 5. You know, I'm going to try and go for about 4 hours because I want it really soft. Oh, I forgot to mention, there's a new addition to my kitchen. I was in my local supermarket and I saw this, and obviously because of the color I had to get it. But this is, you know, traditional slow cooking casserole dish, cast iron. And I think it will change, you know, the way I do things in my kitchen. You know, I'm getting proper tools, so yay! All right, guys, so first thing I'm going to do here is just brown the meat slightly. We'll put in some water, my whole onion, bay leaves, salt, and then just throw it into the oven. My pot is hot. Let's put in about 1 tablespoon of olive oil and just start chucking in your meat. The second batch has browned a little. I'm just adding the remainder. I'll be adding my whole onion. Now just the whole onion. I'm going to add my bay leaves, 3 or 4, and lots and lots of water. Yes, enough to cover it. I had to resist the urge to, you know, put in chicken stock, but this is just a very simple dish, just salt. But I will add some pepper. Okay. So, oh, there we go. I'm just going to give it a little stir. Make sure all the meat is covered. I'm going to cover it up. Now this is going to go into my preheated oven. 150 degrees, and yes, crock pots are hot, so be careful. Go. Hey guys, it's been 4 hours, so here goes nothing. Nice solid pot.
Okay, water's reduced a bit. Looks like it's even browned nicely. Just a little bit. I'm going to just take out the bay leaves and the onions. And there's still a fair bit of liquid in there, so... and look at that. It's perfect. It's just so soft. And breaking away. Taking out my onion. Just going to turn on the stove and just let it cook uncovered, just so the water goes away. So now I'm just going to mash it. Looks like I don't even have to put in too much effort, which is great. Because some people think this is the hardest bit. There we go. I mean, so you see, this is what it's doing, and this is the sort of effect you want to get, the shredded effect. As far as I'm concerned, based on the fact that this was my first attempt, I think we've got what we want here. That's great, isn't it? So the only thing that was missing from this is the bones, you know. It's normally cooked on the bones, but this is effectively what they want. There's some nice pieces of fat there. Just gonna fish those out. Don't really need that. There is the final result. And I'm very pleased with how it's turned out. I've decided to make some polenta. As you can see, polenta. I'll just show you what I'm going to make to accompany it, because, you know, it's a special meal, all in celebration of independence. This is something that can be had at weddings. All I've done is simply chopped up some butternut, put a bit of salt, 1 teaspoon of sugar, a bit of butter, and some cinnamon sticks, and just put it in the oven. And this is just a variation to my other video on how to make lapuzzi. But this is just the no mess, no fuss, hands-free version. So I'm just going to put that in the oven. And what I've made here, I'll be making like just a green bean and broccoli salad, which I'll be dressing with. This is a dressing made with Dijon mustard, a bit of olive oil, a bit of honey, and a little bit of fat-free salad cream. Look, it does the job. So just pour that in there. And you know, it's nice and saucy, so it'll give us a bit of sauce. But just while I've got everything going, why don't I taste the star of the show today, which is Seswaa. There goes nothing. Does it taste authentic? It certainly smells good. I don't know about you, but I think I've nailed it. And it's so, so tender. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you'll try and make it yourselves at home. But until next time, bon appetit!